Let's summarize the barriers in effective communication as discussed in Lecture 29. We'll start with the rules for arrangement of words in a sentence. The preferred order in a sentence is the conjunction, then the subject and agreeing verb, followed by the indirect object and direct object, which should be followed by the place and time. For example, it is easy to understand when I say, because I don't have time now. Similarly, the following sentence is quite clear. Tomorrow, I will tell you the story. Let's take a look at some of the basic structures for sentences. The simplest one is subject, verb, and then object. For example, I speak English. If you wanted to use indirect and direct objects with place and time, the structure would become subject, verb, indirect object, direct object, place, and then time. For example, I will tell you the story at school tomorrow. Adverb of manner is placed after the direct object. So the order becomes subject, verb, direct object, and then adverb. For example, he drove the car carefully. In a question, the interrogative, like how or what, is placed first, followed by the auxiliary verb, the subject, then the other verbs, and then the indirect object, direct object, place, and then time. For example, what would you like to tell me? Or, did you have a party in your flat yesterday? Adverbs of frequency are placed before the main verb, unless the verb is be. So, the order becomes subject, auxiliary verb or be, adverb, main verb, object, place, or time. As in the sentence, I often go swimming in the evenings. At times, there are different faults in communication, which can become barriers in getting the correct message across. One of these are physical barriers. These may be due to defects in the medium used for communication, which may distort the message, delay delivery, or lose the message completely. Another reason may be because there is way too much information or noise in the environment. Another type of barrier in communication is semantic barrier. In this, there may be words that have multiple meanings like charge, which may mean electrical charge or cost of an item. Another semantic fault may appear due to words like wind and wind, which are spelled the same but pronounced differently and have different meanings. There are also words that sound the same but have different spellings and different meanings, like flower or sight. Even with all of this, poor communication skills are yet one of the biggest reasons for semantic and language barriers. Another type of barrier is of the social psychological manner. These are problems of understanding and interpretation of the message due to socially learned and personal attributes of the receiver. A message is received at three levels. The physical level, which involves noticing through the senses. The intelligence level, which deals with the comprehension of the message. And the emotional level, which is a feeling associated with the message, like pleasure, dislike, or indifference. The emotional level is affected by the social psychological barriers. These barriers are based upon attributes such as self-centeredness, group thinking, self-imagery, defensiveness, filtering, and resistance to change of the receiver. The next barrier is the organizational barrier, which is mainly caused due to overdependence on written communication. As a result, misinterpretation or neglection of the message may occur. As culture is a big part of an individual, communication style and competence is influenced by it. Skills in communicating with people of other cultures is vital to success. Cultural differences include language, values, time, space, the thought process, nonverbal behavior, paralanguage, and perceptions. Overcoming these barriers are indeed a challenge, but organizations are making constant efforts for effective communication, which also includes some health programs. The use of visual aids can reduce the effects of these communication barriers. Whereas feedback can also help in improvement of the communication method. Keeping these points in mind can help you communicate effectively every time.